Morning to all. Today's topic is introduction to macroeconomics. Before that, we are going to recall what we have studied in the previous class. So, what is economics? Economics is nothing but a management of household things. Economics has two branches, namely micro and macro economics. It has two branches. So Ragnar Fritsch, a Norwegian economist, who coined the word micro and macroeconomics in 1933. He was the first one who propounded the word micro and macroeconomics in 1933. After that, it began a new form in 1936. John Maynard Keynes. Who explained in his book, The General Theory of Employment, Income and Money. He explained microeconomics in a detailed manner and he is called the father of modern economics. This is a brief introduction what you have studied in the previous class. Now we move on to the today's class, macroeconomics. So, macroeconomics. Micro means small and it studies about the individual households, firms and industries, and it is called as a price theory and study as a part of the economy. But macroeconomics, it is derived from the Greek word macro means large. It deals with the economy as a whole. And it deals with the aggregates of national income, employment, and so on. So it is also called as income theory. So now we have the theorem. Macroeconomics is a Greek word. Macro means large. It deals with the economy as a whole. So a part of microeconomics is called the city area. Or part of the economy. Or industry is called the way or the industry. Or particular industry is called the cover. That way macroeconomics is I am industry is called the way or not. The industry is called the macroeconomics. So mainly we concentrate on the national income, employment, poverty, business cycle, economic growth and economic development. The most important concept is the macroeconomics.